Hello. In this video, I'm going to be talking about upgrading the RAM in a Synology DS718 Plus. And I've done a similar thing in a Synology DS918 Plus. Right now I'm logged into the DSM, and we'll look at the RAM we have now. So if we go to Control Panel and then Info Center, you'll see this has 2048 megabytes of RAM. And Synology lists the max RAM in here as being 6 gigabytes of RAM, and I'm going to test putting in 2 8-gigabyte modules. And I'll put a link in the description to these modules. And I think people have been having trouble with these links in the past. If you click on it, you may need to select the 8-gigabyte module on the Amazon page. But this is my Amazon affiliate link. And if you use that link, it helps me out a little bit, and it doesn't cost anything extra. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to install the RAM, then we'll come back and we'll look and see if it's recognizing 16 gigabytes of RAM. Then I'm actually only going to put a 4-gig module in, but I'm going to put 16 gig in just for testing this, in case anyone else is interested. The reason you would potentially want 16 gigabytes of RAM is if you're running virtual machines. You could say pull up a couple virtual machines, give them each 4 gigabytes of RAM, keep some RAM left over just for the main system. I can't imagine you'd want 16 gig of RAM just to do like file services or something like that. But if you are running a lot of different services on it, certainly having more RAM is useful.
Okay, so I'm at my workbench. I've got the drives out of my 918 and my 718, and I'm going to take the 16 gig out of here and put it in this one. This is kind of tricky to get in here. You can see the RAM is down a ways, so I'll have to reach in and pop it out. I don't have an anti-static wristband on here, but I'm touching the metal on the case to ground myself to the case. So I've got the chip out. So this is the 2 gig, this is the 4 gig out of my 918. When I'm done with this experiment, I'm going to put both of these in the 718. So I've got the RAM out. I have to turn it around. The notches are opposite on these. And this is going to be a little tricky getting this in here. I'm going to do this off camera because I'll have to tip it. Okay, so I have the first chip in there. Okay, I've got the second chip in there. So now I'll replace the hard drives. Okay, and now I'll go plug this in and we'll look at it and see if the RAM is showing up. Now, when you add more RAM, it's going to take, this had 2 gigabytes of RAM. Now it should have 16, so that's 8 times more. So it can take quite a while to boot this up as it tests the RAM. So I'm going to let this boot up and we'll look at the interface once I get it booted, so you don't have to wait through the boot process.
Okay, so I plugged the Synology in. It beeped, so now I'm going to refresh my web interface. I just realized I plugged it into the wrong LAN port. Okay, that's better. So now we'll go to the control panel again, and we'll go to Info Center, and we're showing 16 gigabytes of RAM. So it does seem to work with 16 gigabytes of RAM. I don't know if you get warranty support if you put 16 gig of RAM. You probably want to keep your old chip so you can throw it back in there in case something went wrong. The specs on this chip say it supports 8 gig of RAM, so that should definitely work. But there are other systems that use this same processor that work with 16 gig of RAM. So I run 16 in my 918. That seems to work fine. This one is going to mostly be used for backup. I would leave it at 2 gigabytes, but I have the 4 gigabyte chip from my 918, so I'm going to ultimately set this at 6 gigabytes of RAM. Although for backup, 2 gigabytes is plenty. Like I said before, if you are running virtualization, having more RAM is useful. So if you don't want to go up to 16 gig of RAM, even though this officially supports 6 gig, I'm pretty sure you could put 2 4 gigabyte modules in. And again, I have that link in the description to my Amazon affiliate. My Amazon affiliate link to the memory on Amazon, that helps me out a bit. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. If you like this video, please click like, and thanks for watching. Bye.